Good morning, everybody. That's one of the topics. Diversity of living world. Diversity of living world. Second chapter name, Structural Organization. In animals, third one, animal diversity one, simply called as invertebrate phyla, invertebrate phyla. Fourth chapter name, animal diversity two, chordata phyla, fifth chapter name, locomotion and reproduction in protozoa. Locomotion and reproduction in protozoa. And sixth chapter name, biology in human welfare. Human welfare. Seventh chapter name, Periplaneta Americana. Periplaneta Americana. Eighth chapter name, Ecology and Environment. Ecology and environment. Okay, these are topics in first year zoology. Diversity of living world, structural organization in animals, animal diversity one, simply invertebrate phyla, animal diversity two, simply chordata phyla, fifth chapter name, locomotion and reproduction in protozoa, and sixth one, biology in human welfare, seventh one, Periplaneta Americana, eighth one, ecology and environment. Okay, and here the first chapter, diversity of living world. Diversity of living world. Okay, before that, before this topic, and you know, these are the living things, those are the living things. How do you recognize living things and non-living things? And here, simply living things have the life, non-living things do not have the life. And here, what is the difference between unicellular and multicellular organisms? And here, uni means single. Uni means single. The unicellular organism means single cellular organism. Unicellular organism means single cellular organism. Example, protozoa. Example, protozoa. Like, organism like Euglena, Paramecium, etc., etc. these are the example of unicellular organism. Okay, simply the example of unicellular organism belongs to the phylum of protozoa. Example Euglena, Paramecium. And here these single cell perform the total functions of its body. Okay, that's why it is called unicellular organism. It is simply called as they consist of single cell. That's why they are called as unicellular organism. The single cell perform the total functions of its body, like circulation, okay, and excretion. Excretion means, circulation means what here? The blood pass from one place to another place. Circulation and excretion. Excretion means elimination of waste material from body. Elimination of waste material from body is called excretion. And here locomotion, okay, movement of the organism from one place to another place. Respiration, okay. And here exchange the gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide is simply called as respiration. And here single cell perform the total functions of its body. It is belongs to the Euglena and Paramecium, belongs to the protozoa phylum. Next one is the multicellular organism. Multicellular organism. Here multi means more than one. Multi means more than one organism. Okay. Multi means more than one. Cellular means cells. Okay. And here they consist the number of organism, number of cells. That's why it is simply called as multicellular organisms. And here the multicellular organisms consist the special organs for specific function. The multicellular organisms consist the special organs for specific function. Okay. And here, for example, human being, better example of multicellular organism. We have the special digestive system help to the digestion purpose. We have the special excretory system. We have the special circulatory system. Okay. And here the each system perform the specific function. Each system perform the specific function. It is the difference between unicellular and multicellular organisms. And here first chapter name, diversity of living world. Diversity of living world. And you know how to recognize these are living things, those are living things. You know only one factor, I think. And here the living things consist the life. Non-living things do not have the life. Okay. And here not only that, the living things move from one place to another place. Non-living things cannot move from one place to another place. And here, not only that, the living things exhibit the factors. Living things exhibit the factors like living things exhibit the factors. Like cellular organization, cellular organization, second one is the complexity of organization, complexity of organization. Third one is the sensitivity आर रेस्पॉन्ड टू एनवायरमेंट, रेस्पॉन्ड टू एनवायरमेंट। फोर्थ वन इज द ग्रोथ फिफ्थ वन इज द रिप्रोडक्शन सिक्स्थ वन इज द मेटाबॉलिज्म सेवन्थ वन इज द होमियोस्टासिस एट वन इज द एवोल्यूशन नाइन्थ वन इज द सेंसेंस टेंथ वन इज द मोर्टालिटी। ओके द लिविंग थिंग्स एक्सपीरियंस द फैक्टर्स लाइक सेलुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सेंसिटिविटी और रेस्पॉन्ड टू एनवायरमेंट ग्रोथ रिप्रोडक्शन मेटाबॉलिज्म होमियोस्टासिस एवोल्यूशन सेनेसेंस मोर्टालिटी। ओके फर्स्ट वन इज द सेलुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन द एवरी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइफ स्टार्ट विद द सिंगल सेल दैट्स व्हाई सेल इज कॉल्ड स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ द बॉडी structural and functional unit of the body every living organism life start with single cell that's why cell is called structural and functional unit of the body okay And here, next one is the complexity of organization. And here, from the one level to another level, the complexity increased or depthness increased from one level to another level. Okay? And here, atoms. Group of atoms form molecules. Group of molecules. Here, straight one. Atoms. Group of atoms form molecules. Group of molecules form cell. Group of cell form tissues. Group of tissues form organs. Group of organs form organ system. Group of organ systems form organism. Group of organisms form population. Group of population form community. Group of communities form ecosystem. Group of ecosystems form biosphere. bios here. Okay, and here complexity increase in the each level, and here the group of atoms from the molecules, group of molecules from the cells, group of cells from the tissues, group of tissues from the organs, group of organs from the organ systems, group of organ systems from the organism, group of organism from the population, group of population from the community, group of community from the ecosystem, group of ecosystems from the biosphere. Here complexity increase, depthness increase in the each level. For example, cell. Okay, and here the group of cells form the tissues, and here group of tissues form the organ. Here the cell is simple level. The group of cells from the tissues, here complexity increase from when you compare the cell to group of cells. Okay, and here complexity increase the tissue to organ. Here each level complexity increase, that is simply called as complexity of organization. Here remember one thing, the living things and non-living things consist the atoms and molecules. Living things and non-living things consist the molecules and atoms. But in the living things, molecules help to the formation of cells. But in the non-living things, molecules cannot help with the formation of the cell. Why? Because in the living things, consider the atoms and molecules consider little bit of space. Okay, and here this space filled with the protoplasm or living fluid. Okay, the protoplasm or living fluid help to the formation of cells, tissues, etc. Okay, the cell consisting the fluid is called cytoplasm. Okay, and here the non-living things arrangement of atoms and molecules very closely tight packing. There is no gap between the atoms and molecules. In the non-living things, but in the living things, they have the gap between the atoms, between the molecules. Okay, that is the difference between both living and non-living things. Okay, next one is the sensitivity or respond to environment. The every living organism respond to the internal and external stimulus. Sensitivity or respond to environment. Every living organism respond to the internal and external stimulus. Okay, the internal stimulus means here the hormones, or body produce the hormones, respond to the hormones, and the external factors like sunlight, heat, cold. Okay, that every living organism responded to the internal and external stimulus. Next one is the growth. The growth is necessary for all living things, in the animals, in the plants, etc. And here in the animals, growth see only certain age of life. But in the plants, the growth see throughout their life, the animal grows in certain age of life. For example, human 80 to 90, and here. But in the plants, the growth seen throughout their life. It is the fundamental factor. The growth is the fundamental factor in the every living thing. Next one is the reproduction. Next one is the reproduction. And here, reproduce the organism is called reproduction. Reproduce the organism is simply called as reproduction. It is two types: sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction. First one is the sexual reproduction. Fusion of male and female gametes is called sexual reproduction. The reproduction is two types: sexual, asexual. First one is the sexual reproduction. Fusion of male and female gametes is called sexual reproduction. Okay. Next one is the asexual reproduction. Next one is the asexual reproduction. And here only uniparent, uni means single parent, involve the reproduction. Single parent produce the daughters, individuals, is called asexual reproduction. Here without involvement of gametes, without involvement of gametes seen in the asexual reproduction. Here asexual reproduction, budding process, types of asexual reproduction: budding process, binary fission, binary fission, and third one is the fragmentation. First one, the budding process. Okay, and for example, the budding process commonly seen in the Hydra. Hydra, yeast bacteria. Hydra and yeast bacteria. And here, these bird cut from the parent. Divide from the parent and form into the new individual. Form into the new individual. It is one of the organism. These birds separated and form the new individual is called budding process. It is commonly seen in the Hydra and yeast. Next one is the binary fission. Binary fission commonly seen in the protozoa organism. Okay, especially paramecium, euglena. Binary fission commonly seen in the paramecium and euglena. Okay, and here in the binary fission means here the parent organism divide and form the two daughter individuals is called binary. Here by means two. Here the parent divided and form to the two daughter individuals is called binary fission. It is commonly found in the protozoa organism like paramecium and euglena. Next one is the fragmentation. the parent organism break down and form the number of daughter individuals. Number of daughter individuals is called fragmentation. It is found in the planaria organism. Planaria organism. Next one is the metabolism. Next one is the metabolism. And here the contribution of anabolism and catabolism. Contribution of anabolism and catabolism is called metabolism. Contribution of anabolism and catabolism is called metabolism. Anabolism means it is constructive process. Constructive process. The catabolism is destructive process. In the anabolism, it is commonly found in the photosynthesis process. It is store the food material. Anabolism process, constructive process. It is commonly seen in the photosynthesis, and catabolism is the destructive process, breakdown process. Destructive process means breakdown process, destructive process simply. Okay, and here it is commonly seen in the respiration. Okay, the contribution of both like anabolism and catabolism is called metabolism. Okay. Contribution of anabolism and catabolism is simply called as metabolism. The anabolism commonly seen in the photosynthesis. Catabolism commonly seen in the respiration process. Okay. Another name of metabolism, energy utilization. Another name of metabolism, energy utilization. Another name of the metabolism, energy utilization. Once, the diversity of living world. Okay, the living things exhibit the factors like cellular level of organization, complexity of organization, sensitivity, growth, reproduction, metabolism. Another name of metabolism, energy utilization, and homeostasis, evolution, senescence and mortality. Senescence and mortality. These 10 chapters recognize the living things. Okay. And here the atoms and molecules both are same in the living and non-living things. But in the living things, atoms and molecules consider little bit of space, help to the formation of the cells. The space filled with the protoplasm or living fluid help to the formation of cells. But in the non-living things, atoms and molecules arrangement very close. Okay, atoms and molecules arrangement very close. Okay, and here there is no gap between the atoms and molecules. That's why protoplasm or living plasm is absent. Okay, that is the reason. In the non-living things cannot form the cells. And the remaining topics tomorrow onwards. Okay.